Hello everyone, welcome to WebSensePro, welcome to latest video for Elementor 3.19 beta. Yes, Elementor has released latest version in which they have added some cool features which we're gonna show you guys what are those. So let me give you a brief introduction of what you'll be learning in this video. So Elementor has added a feature where you can set visibility for every single element. Previously it was not available. You were able to set visibility for the pages and post, but now you can set that on element level. Now you can also display some of the elements to specific users. So for example, if you want to enable few elements just for the subscriber level user, you can do that. And if you want editor level to have only specific elements to access, you can do that. You will get the more details in the rest of the video. So make sure to watch the complete video, subscribe to our channel, comment in the video below. And the third feature which they added in Elementor 3.19 is creating new templates using AI. So that's also a really cool feature. So if you create any container, now you'll be able to create variations using AI tool which they have added in Elementor. So if you want to see all of these features in action, make sure to watch the complete video. So without further ado, let's get into the screen.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSensePro. I'm your co-host Nidashik with another feature release video on Elementor. Yes, Elementor 3.19 beta is now available and you guys can use it. And this is the first time that they have given us the experience to use the display condition for elements on your website. I'll tell you step by step what amazing features this new 3.19 beta has brought for us. So stay with me. Okay guys, so first of all, I'll be showing you guys how you can use the display setting option. For that purpose, all you need to do is click Elementor and go to settings. Okay, in features, make sure the display condition option is active. If it is deactivated, you need to activate first and then click save changes. Okay, I've already activated it. Now, let me show you guys how you can use it. Let's add a new page here. Okay guys, so the page is inserted here. Now let's just add some post here. Okay guys, so this is a dummy post which I have added for you guys. All you need to do is choose this post here, go to advanced. Okay, when you scroll down from the left hand side, you can see display condition on your left side. Okay, now you need to choose this display condition here. This option was previously not available in the old version, but in the new version, you can choose conditions, you can add certain conditions to it. Okay, so if you want, for example, a certain day of the week on in which this post needs to be visible, which is really good for the website makers, okay, is not day of the week, you can choose the day of the week, the server time, and you can click save and close. Or if you want, for example, let me show you one more option. If you want to set certain roles to the condition, you can choose the role here. For example, only the subscriber can see it, the administrator, editor, author, anything you want. So all you need to do is choose the role, click save and close, and the condition will be applied to it. Okay guys, let me show you the second most important addition in Elementor 3.19 beta. Okay, for that purpose, from the left side, go to Elementor here, click Element Manager. Okay, previously what we were getting is that we can either activate a widget or deactivate it, but now we have this permission option. For example, I want the audio, okay, add animated headlines, click okay. You can select the roles which you want to see the widget. This is going to be super easy. Once this setting is done, it's going to be really easy for the users. Okay, you want this to be visible for the editor only, the author only, the contributor only. You can choose this on your own. For example, if I don't want the author to see it, I can click this. I don't want the editor to see it, I can click this. Okay, so this is super easy and now the things are getting even more better for us. Okay guys, one more thing which Elementor 3.19 beta has given us is the generate container variation from the template library. With the help of this, you can enhance your building experience by generating AI container variation directly from Elementor's template library. This version adds a generate variation button to the template library, which provides three different AI-based versions of the template, each with its own layout. Let me show you guys. For example, this is just a dummy page. I want to add variations for this first. Okay, what I'll do is I'll choose this dotted container option and I'll click generate variation with AI. Okay, let's choose this. Okay, all you need to do is press this and then we'll get some suggestion. Okay, minimalistic design with bold typography about, okay, let's choose this about nature. Let me show you guys how it works. Okay, once you have written what you want for your post, what AI will do is it will generate three different variations of the post you want, and you can simply click generate here and choose the layout. I'll show you what they have written in their website as well. This is how it works. They have given, for example, here section with an image headline and call to action button about marketing agency, and these are the three options the AI has given them, and you can click this and use the layout. Okay guys, I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below.